Hello, and welcome to the show that searches out the hidden treasures in your home and then sells them for you at auction. Now, sometimes it's not just these smaller items that get handed down from generation to generation. Sometimes it's the whole house. And that's exactly the case with the family I'm meeting today. They're hoping that with our help and a good clear out, they'll find some cash in the attic. On today's Cash in the Attic, a novel use for a World War I helmet.
If you want to find a home for your aspidistra, there you go.
Jonty lifts the lid on a 19th century method of insect repellent.
They put a lid on simply to stop the flies from dropping into your beer.
And when we get to auction, we'll be toasting success.
Forget cracking open the egg, crack open the champagne, I say.
And when that final hammer falls, will the corks still be popping?
45 and gone.
I'm in Croydon, on my way to meet a brother and sister who've decided to sell their family home. But first, they've found some interesting items that used to belong to their dad that they're hoping to sell at auction and raise money to share with the family. John Stelling has lived in this four-bedroomed semi-detached house for the past 21 years. He co-owned it with his father, who sadly passed away in 2009. John trained as a mechanical engineer and in his spare time loves working on cars. He's currently restoring an old Volkswagen Beetle for one of his sisters. He's also built several sports cars from kit form, including this Lotus 7 replica. Joining John for the rummage today is his sister Kate, who lives nearby with her family.
Hey, Jonty, good to see you.
How are you doing?
I'm not bad at all. We've got a sort of meeting like this.
I know.
I'm looking forward to this. High hopes, I think.
I know. Should we get straight in?
You go in through the front door. I'm going to go in through the garage.
Okay.
Try something different.
Okay.
With 20 years' experience in the antiques trade, Jonty Hearnden starts our hunt for collectibles indoors, while I go in search of our hosts.
Ah, so you two must be the brother and sister.
There we are.
Hi, John, Kate, how are you? Was she bossing you around then?
Ah, she always bossing me
around. Just heard her say, where are you going to put the stereo? There's a long way before that, I'd say.
Yeah, there is.
So go on, why have you called in the Cash in the Attic team?
Because my dad's got quite a few antiques in the house and memorabilia, and we just don't really know where to go and what to do with it. So we thought we'd give you guys a call.
And how much money are we hoping to raise here?
About £1,500.
£1,500?
Well, all three of us. It's me and my brother and my sister.
Ah, okay.
So,
right.
You know.
What are you hoping to do with it?
Well, I'd like to get my personal car done up here.
Okay, right. And how about you, John?
Well, I'll probably sell it up and maybe, I don't know, get a boat.
Really?
Yeah, why not?
What, sail around the world?
Well, I don't know about that.
Well, listen, £1,500 is a lot of money to find. The good news is that it's not just us searching. We've got the expert eye of Jonty, and I should let you know that he's already let himself into your house. He's already having a rummage. So should we go and find out how he's getting on?
Yeah,
come on, follow me.
There's 2 years between John and his older sister, Kate. Their other sister, Mandy, is 2 years older again. Between them, they have a plethora of interests, all to be covered by that £1,500 target. Jonty's roughing it in the garden shed. It seems to be a storehouse for wartime memorabilia, a pet subject of John and Kate's father.
Oh, there you are.
So this is where you've been hiding.
Well, I saw the shed from the house, so I thought I'd come and have a look.
What you found?
That looks like an interesting shed as well, doesn't it?
I found a British helmet and a German helmet here. Now this one, this German helmet, looks like it's seen better days. It looks like it's been a plant pot holder or something like that. Now, because it's got no lining, I think that this is First World War rather than Second World War.
What's the story behind these then?
That was our dad's.
This was dad's, was it?
It's in good nick, that as well, isn't
it? I know. Can you just hold on for me? This is wonderful to actually have this original netting on there as well. It actually adds value, because what we're looking at here are collectible items.
So who'd buy this?
Well, there's a lot of interest in militaria per se, right away across the board. So, of course, items from the Second World War, items from the First World War, great interest still.
And if you've got a lovely little plant that you haven't got a home for, you can always buy that.
There.
If you want to find a home for your aspidistra, there you go.
What's it all worth?
Well, we can certainly put these two together. You've got any more bits and pieces like this?
Yeah, I think I've got some more stuff that my dad's kept in his wardrobe.
We'll put it all in one lot. And because this is in such good condition, these two items, 100 to 150 pounds.
Wow, yeah,
fantastic. Whoa. Well, don't get too cocky. It's only 150 pounds. We need to find 1,500 pounds. So onwards and upwards. Can we go in?
Yes.
It's freezing.
It is cold out there.
Freezing.
John also turns out a leather pilot's cap and a gas mask that his father had collected, which gets us off to a good start. But we have a large house to search, so we'd better get cracking. In the dining room, Jonty spots this cottage dining table, made in mahogany, more than 100 years old. It used to belong to John's great uncle. It hasn't been used for years. Showing a little damage, it's valued at 30 to 50 pounds. I'm busy exploring the lounge, but everyone else seems to think the kitchen is the place to be.
I've got this.
Well, that's nice.
I found.
Jonty?
Yeah.
Look what we found.
Ooh, beer steins. Those look wonderful. Where were these from?
I think these are my dad's and he brought them back from his travels.
They're very decorative objects, aren't they? Of course, designed to drink your ale out of, your beer. So if I do a little swapsy there with you, Kate. This one here has a lid. And the whole purpose of a lid in the 15th and 16th century was to stop insects from dropping into your beer. Because at that time there was a massive problem with flies. And if you can see here, look at the decoration around the outside. It has a 19th century feel, but this is really an interpretation of a 19th century style. So these are great fun, but let's have a look at this one. So if I just swap with you there, this one is completely different. This is pewter. It has a lid for the same purpose, but this is a little cream jug or milk jug. And if we turn it upside down, it says here, made by Liberty & Co., English pewter. And if you look here, can you see how simple this is?
Yeah, very simple.
This is the style of Liberty, and it's what made it so famous, and it's the reason why people collect Liberty designs from this period, made out of pewter. So this is the item that's going to attract the dealers. So we'll put the three in together, make it as one lot, and we're looking at sort of 30, 50 pounds.
All right.
Okay.
Happy about that?
Yeah.
No, it's not a vast sum of money, but it does mean that we've got to go and find some more bits.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll go this way.
50 pounds, here we go, 50 pounds.
When the tankards get to auction, will time be called on the gentleman in the room?
5, 80, 5, 90.
And will the bidding run out of control?
That's our Liberty jug for you.
That's ridiculous.
Our search at the Stellings family home continues. John and Kate's father left behind so many collectibles to go through. I'm quite immersed in this box of old records, mainly 78s, which is why there are no recordings of mine in there. You were thinking that, weren't you? Kate's looking through one of the bedrooms. She's the lucky one, finding a miniature Singer sewing machine tucked away in a box. This machine was first marketed back in 1910, sold as both a toy and an adult miniature. With a 20 to 30 pound estimate, this ought to perform well on sale day. Well, we haven't sewn up our antiques hunt just yet. Time to find out more about John and Kate's dad.
I've got to admit to you that I don't know this area very well. All I really know is that the Fairfield Hall is just down the road where I used to sing quite a bit. But what's this area like?
It's a lovely area, actually.
It's
a nice area to grow up in, you know, for the children. And
you grew up here as well, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
And you've been, what, in this house for 21 years?
21 years, yeah.
And for quite a bit of that time, you lived here, just you and your dad. What was that like?
Up and down. Sort of had our moments.
They were like Steptoe and Son.
That's a good thing, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, they were.
Let's talk a little bit about your dad. What sort of character was he?
He was just a loving, caring dad. He really was. And, he always had time for everybody else. Always put everyone else first.
Has it been quite tough for you coming back?
It has, because I pop in here all the time to see my brother, but it's the first time in a long time that I've actually been in here all day.
And the last few years of his life were tough on him, but also tough on you, weren't they?
Yeah, it was very tough. My dad was, very ill in the last 3.5 years, and just watching him become dependent on us was very sad.
What's it going to be like selling some of his stuff at auction, then? Is that part of the healing process for you?
Yeah, in a way, I think it
is.
Yeah,
I guess so. It's moving on, isn't it? Yeah, we'll bring the hankies, won't we?
And the sunglasses.
Let's hope it's not that bad.
You're not singing, are you?
I'm not. What do you think he'd be saying now if he's looking down on us?
I think he'd be amused that we've actually, you know, sort of done this. He used to love watching programmes like this all the time. And for us to actually have rung you guys and get you to come in and have a rummage round, I think he'd be proud of what we've done, actually.
Yeah.
Well, listen, that £1,500 ain't going to find itself, so I think we should carry on with the rummage. Is that all right?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go.
Going by Jonty's lowest estimate so far, we stand to make £180 when we take the items to auction. So we're still a long way off that target of £1,500. Well, I'm pleased to say that I make the next discovery. It's a late Victorian sterling silver Vesta case, named after the Roman goddess of the hearth. Matches were known as Vestas until the early 20th century. Because the phosphorus used to make the early Vestas was unstable, one needed cases to keep them safe. Jonty values this one at £20 to £30.
Hi guys, what do you think of this one?
Oh, blimey. I know that Christmas song I sang was bad, but...
Where did you find that?
I was just wrapped in a cloth in my dad's wardrobe.
Wow.
Really?
It's incredible.
Can I have a look? There's no grey area when it comes to selling arms like this, because it's completely illegal to have this in your possession if it can be used. So I'm assuming that this has been decommissioned. What's the story?
Oh, yeah, it's been decommissioned. I don't know when, quite a few years ago.
So do you have any paperwork, certificates?
Yeah, we've got a certificate with it.
Oh, well, that's really good news for us, because it means that we can therefore sell it on the open market. This is a Smith & Wesson copy. So guns like this, or pistols like this, were used by the British officers during the First World War. And when I say copy, the British Army were concerned that they were going to run out of pistols like this, so they commissioned Spanish factories, in fact, three Spanish factories, to produce a pistol like this. It was a bolt-on to the British Army during the First World War. So it's almost 100 years old.
Yet more army memorabilia. Let's talk about Wonga. How much?
I think we're looking at £200 to £300 worth of pistols.
Really?
Yeah.
Close examination of the paperwork shows that this revolver was decommissioned back in 1995 and cannot be made to fire again, so it is acceptable for inclusion in a general auction. There are strict laws governing the ownership of weapons and their sale. Your auction house should be able to advise. Now then, our hunt for collectibles is still going strong in South London. Kate is still searching the bedrooms, and I hope John will forgive me for thinking he may have returned to his car maintenance. I'm obviously wrong, and he's doing us proud. He's actually dug out an old Meccano set that's a family heirloom. This aeroplane was built by John's dad when he was a child. The box contains the original parts from the set, with some spares too. A Meccano is still very popular, and this little lot could fetch £50 to £100 at auction.